When I first began working in this unit, which was in 2003, fentanyl had just finished coming through the city in like a wave.
The illicit use of synthetic opioids like fentanyl is nothing new in Baltimore. In the current crisis, however, these drugs are more pervasive than ever before.
Now what we're seeing is a steady pace of fentanyl cases in all different types. So you might get a case that is just fentanyl. You might get a case where it's fentanyl and heroin mixed together. You might get a case where it's fentanyl and cocaine mixed together. I had fentanyl and ketamine recently. To us, they're just throwing stuff together that doesn't make any sense. This stuff will kill people, like, immediately. Some of the mixtures we've seen will kill people immediately.
These lethal and unprecedented mixtures are forcing forensic chemists to face new challenges and dangers. To learn about those, we visited Monique Pitts of the Drug Analysis Unit at the Baltimore Police Department.
Right now, we don't have really any good preliminary tests for fentanyl, but we also want to minimize everyone's exposure. So we take safety precautions with everything. We try not to even open the packages very much anymore, or we use our hoods all the time. Everyone wears masks. We assume fentanyl is in everything now.
Previously, chemists could use quick and simple test reactions that changed color or produced a precipitate to get some idea of what's in a sample. With more potent drug samples coming into Pitt's lab now, taking multiple samples for those tests puts analysts at greater risk. At the U.S. National Institute for Standards and Technology, Jennifer Verkouteren and Ed Sisko are working to vet analytical tools that could help replace those rapid preliminary tests. But that process takes time, and Verkouteren is still concerned about the demand shouldered by people on the front line of the opioid crisis.
Everything gets treated as if it could be very dangerous. And so they can't sort of triage and say, okay, it's only these materials that we have to be very concerned about. And I think that probably will lead to problems with fatigue. You simply can't go day to day, treating everything as if it's a chemical warfare agent.
Although Pitts and her colleagues don't rely on preliminary tests anymore, they can still trust their more powerful analytical instruments to identify unknown compounds.
The GCMS, gas chromatograph mass spectrometer, the old faithful, the FTIR, if it's a pure sample. But GCMS is pretty good. Yes.
The trade-off is that these tools require more time and sample prep than the old preliminary tests. But with improved safety protocols, Pitts and her team are prepared to continue doing their jobs until technology catches up.
We always need more resources, but the main thing is for us to continue to get more safety procedures in place. As the global market for illicit drugs grows, it's just going to get way more complicated, so we just have to continue with what we're doing and like I said, put in for more instruments, more people, and we see what happens. We'll see what happens. Yep. Yeah.